Have you ever met someone that you are instantly attracted to, but you just can't seem to quite get their attention? Now, the good news is we have all been in this position at least once or twice, and flirting is so important because it shows the other person that we are interested in them and that we want to get to know them a little bit better. Flirting doesn't always mean laughing at every joke they say and doing a Cosmo hair flip. It's all about being authentically you because, newsflash, you are amazing, and being able to confidently flirt is not an actual talent that you are naturally born with. Some people, it might seem as they are. It's actually something that you learn and you perfect and you fail and then you learn to not fail. And in today's video, we are going to learn how to flirt with confidence so that the next time you are talking to your crush, you well and truly ace it. So let's take a look at some flirting tips and techniques that will help us win over our crushes. You have to stop being cheesy. Let's start with this very fundamental and important tip. Have you ever been on a dating app and found yourself very turned off because someone used a cheesy chat-up line in their bio? Now, sometimes these lines can be amusing, but mostly they are very outdated. And in today's world, everybody appreciates authenticity and thoughtfulness. So talk to your crush or your date in the same way that you would talk to a friend. And this way, your date gets to know the real you, and you get to know the real them as well. Because this will show if you really like them and if they like you too. So don't be scared about showing them your personality. And if you find out that you guys aren't clicking as much as you thought you might have done, that's okay. They are not the person for you, and it's better to know that now rather than 5 years down the line sitting on an armchair getting annoyed every time you hear them exhale. Practice this mantra in the mirror, and it should help you gain the confidence to stop hiding behind the pickup lines and show the real you. Repeat in the mirror, "I just want to let this person know that I am interested." And you know what? Despite what you think, it works amazingly well because it's going to take the pressure off the whole situation and allow you to just be yourself. Make eye contact. This tip, it's simple, but it's very important. Take a moment to think back to someone that you were really attracted to and immediately were drawn to. They probably made a lot of eye contact with you. And eye contact is a great way to show someone that you are interested in them and that you are valuing and listening to them. This makes them feel very valued, appreciated, and respected. And if you are not confident in your eye contact skills, don't you worry. It's something that you can practice. You want it to feel authentic and not fake, and it's awkward when you first learn to do it, but it gets better. The University of Michigan did some research into eye contact back in 2012, and they developed the 50 to the 70 rule and suggest that during a conversation you should make eye contact 50% of the time while speaking and 70% while listening. And in between these eye contact moments, you can sip on your drink, use the bathroom, swipe another Tinder date, depending on how bad it's going. This balance between eye contact and non-eye contact will display interest and uber confidence. Pay them a compliment. Who doesn't love a compliment? It makes everyone feel very special, valued, and important, which will help your date become instantly attracted to you. For some, paying compliments comes easy, but for others, it can be very overwhelming and scary because it means you have to display some form of vulnerability. And if this is you, it's completely normal to feel a little bit weird. Don't worry about it. Don't let this get in your way though, because as I said above, flirting confidently is a skill, and don't worry, I'm here to help you. First of all, when it comes to compliments, it's important that it is a genuine compliment, which means it's not something that you can prep beforehand, like questions, for example. You may choose to compliment their hair, their eyes, their outfit, or their personality, but if you do go for something aesthetic, make sure it's unique and something that you can say, "I like your eyes because of this, this, this." A good rule of thumb is make sure this compliment is something that you would genuinely really want to hear about yourself, and your date will really appreciate those kind words and also the authenticity behind the compliment. And if you do this well, you will have them melting in your hands, like I am in the studio today, a complete ice cream on the studio floor. ask questions. I am sure that you love it when someone asks you an interesting question as much as I do. It makes you feel as if that person was paying attention to you and is very interested in you romantically or in a friendly way. So, the best way to come up with interesting questions is to listen to what they actually say. Maybe it's your second date and you've remembered something that they said on the first date. Maybe they said, "I used to work in a clothes shop." Well, this little fact will open up so many doors where you can ask all sorts of questions. For example, "So what type of clothes did you sell in that shop that you worked in?" Or even, "Where was that shop that you said that you worked in?" Now, it might sound funny to ask a question like this, but actually, if the shop is near somewhere that you have been before, boom, you have a connection topic that you can keep on flowing. And if it is your first date, then spend some time before the date thinking about some questions that you could ask, or maybe even stalking their social media to find out a bit more about them. Don't over-prepare though, because you want the date to be natural, but think of some questions that you would like to be asked. For example, "So, what do you do as a job? What is your favourite food? Do you like pineapple and pizza?" These can lead to fun conversations and allow you to flirt with confidence. Be your funny self. Being funny is one of the best flirting techniques. Someone that can make you laugh is instantly attractive. And I don't mean knock-knock jokes, although sometimes they can be a little bit funny. And if you can bring in some natural humour, your crush will be hooked. You don't have to be mega confident to be funny. That's a complete bogus myth. And in fact, I am at my most funny when I'm a little bit nervous, because I think we can all agree that we use humour as a coping mechanism. And yeah, I know I'm not the only one that does it. So turn your first date nerves into something positive and channel them into your humour. Of course, I wouldn't recommend turning everything into a joke, and make sure the humour that you use is not unkind in any way. Stick to jokes that you both find funny, and you will find yourself becoming the master guru of flirting. Don't forget to smile. Smiling, really, despite what you think, is the best medicine. Did you ever see someone with a big smile on their face and you can't help but mirror it? Smiling makes people feel instantly attracted to you because it makes them feel warm. And this means that your crush feels as if they can really trust you, which is important, especially if you enter into a relationship with them. In 2013, a neurological study found that a smiling face can actually activate a region in your brain that processes sensory rewards. So your smile literally makes somebody else happy. And I always say that a smile is a free gift that you can give to those around you. Smiling is a great flirting technique, and it's an easy one to do. And not only will it make your date feel special and happy, but it will also let them know that you are interested in them. Draw attention to your lips. I'm so guilty of this one. Although it's not a crime, in fact, it really works in your favour. This flirting tip is amazing. Draw attention to your lips while talking to your crush, and it will drive them wild. You can do it by putting a finger at the corner of your mouth for a moment like that, and this will bring the attention to the lips. And it will start to get them thinking about what it would be like to kiss you. And that's all part of the flirting techniques, right? So next time you are on a date, make sure to apply some chapstick and keep it topped up. Make sure it's in your pocket, in your car, in your handbag, wherever you keep it. And remember that anyone can wear chapstick, so you can buy some at your local supermarket. Coconut is my personal favourite flavour. Let me know down in the comments what you thought of today's video, but if you want to go ahead and binge some more content, feel free. However, if you do want to up-level your mindset and also your skill set when it comes to psychology and relationships, there are so many books down below in the description bar that I have personally read and I absolutely love them. And also, a percentage of that sale actually comes back to the channel as a way to say thanks for us putting out content every single day. Another way that you can say a huge thanks to me and everyone else on the channel is signing up to our Superfan membership. It's a monthly subscription service where you get access to exclusive things that no one else does. And of course, you get your name rolling up at the end of every single video. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.